So what we've got here, guys, is the Lush, which is our women's specific design all mountain bike. So some of the big features of the bike are 120 mils travel front and rear. And some of the women's specific features on the bike does come with a women's specific design seat from Bontrager. Some of the other things are it does have a very steeply sloped drop tube there, which basically just means it's easier for the shorter ladies to hop on and off the bike.
I used to always use men's shoes. Then stepping into a women's specific shoe was a great big deal. There's less volume, and it's more that the shoe will mold to your feet, and it keeps it nice throughout.
We're standing in front of a men's bike today. Tell us about the women's bikes and how they're going to be different to this.
Well, probably the key difference is that it's going to be a shorter top tube. It's going to be a shorter stem within the geometries. And the seat is going to be slightly different there as well. So a little bit wider for the sit bones. And essentially a specific women's bike for their particular build.
Fantastic. And then the suspension side of things, does that change at all, or does it stay pretty similar between men's and women's?
It stays fairly similar between men's and women's, and what you have is a fantastic Scott bike with great technology across both men's and women's, just with those slight differences there for the geometry.
My bike, it's very great. I like it. My wheel, it's 650B, so for me it's a good compromise, because I like a nervous bike, and for the technical section I feel very good and very speed with my beige bike, and so it's light and nice design, so perfect for me.
This race I'm riding the World Cup Epic. It's a new bike this year from Specialized. I absolutely love it. It feels more like a hardtail, but it has a little bit of suspension. So on these hard technical climbs, and especially on the couple of drops, I don't know if you've seen the course, but the couple of drops and rocky sections, you have that little extra bit of suspension. So it's really the best of both worlds on that.
Right. And is that technically a men's bike that you're on?
Yeah, this one is a men's bike. I ride the Fate, which is a women's specific bike, and then I've ridden also the Rumor, which is a women's specific bike.
Okay. And to get this to fit you, are there any modifications you make from the stock setup?
This one actually fit me really well from the beginning. I changed the stem, changed the seat height, but it is pretty close.
Kind of get Specialized cross-country racing. Can you tell us a bit about how the women's bikes differ from the men's?
Well, we've got two riders here. We've got Kate Courtney, USA rider, and Teresa. And Teresa riding the Fate, which is a hardtail, and Kate's on the Epic, the full suspension one. So there's a bit difference on the setup and different wheels, obviously, for different bikes. There is a difference in the women's Fate one. Obviously, the geometry is quite a bit different on it. So that's why Teresa likes it. The angles in the front, she's comfortable on it, especially in the drops in here. And for the climbing as well, it's pretty responsive.
From China, they made a whole range just for girls, so it has the top tube is a bit shorter because girls in general have longer girls and got longer legs than the guys. So it feels really good to ride it. The handling is very easy. We ride 27.5 inch wheels, so it's easy to steer and very playful to ride.
There's more of the same coming soon, so don't forget to click subscribe. And let us know what you think of the series so far in the comments section below.